Já, hvernig, how did I get in touch with Elín, ekki, sagði ekki?
Jú.
Já.
Og hvað svona fyrir Elín var sér?
Já. I met Mike at an art opening at Airwaves. Yeah, and we started talking there. And we had been talking about using one of my songs for Siggi's skate part in for the Ailey Workshop skate part. And he happened to come to a art exhibit that I had over Airwaves and just casually asked me if I want to do a board graphic, which I immediately said yes to. And of course I knew Alien Workshop from my skating days. One of my first real skateboard was the Evolution board from Alien Workshop. One with a monkey and an alien and woman. Growing up skateboarding in Reykjavik was it was fun, but we didn't have very much of a no big skate parks or anything like that. We have one very nice skate spot called Ingolstorg. It was kind of almost looks like it was made for skateboarding, and I guess that's where we spent most of our time. And it was great. I met lots of my friends, who are still my friends today. And yeah, it was great being part of that culture. It was lots of the people who I was skating with as a teenager have gone on to being musicians or filmmakers or photographers, and I think skateboarding culture is a very do-it-yourself kind of a thing. You know, we started doing like taking photographs of ourselves skateboarding and filming skate videos, and I think lots of that stuff led us to, you know, do other creative things when we grew up. I first got my first skateboard when I was 7, after bugging my parents for it for a while, and I of course I can't remember what the brand of the skateboard, it was a pro model by someone called Malone, and I started off with falling right on my face and like getting scabs all over my face, and yeah, then maybe the first real skateboard I bought was the Evolution deck by Alien, and yeah, I wasn't very good at skateboarding, I guess, but I really enjoyed it. And I dislocated my elbow when I was 13, and then again when I was 14, and then again when I was 15. And yeah, I guess after dislocating my elbow 3 times, I didn't put as much work into skateboarding, but I still had pretty much the same friends that I made when I was skateboarding, and I still have them today. I think it was just also a very good, you know, thing to do, because it was not like sports where you're trying to beat another team. It's you know, just something you do with your friends, and there's no winning or losing. Yeah, and it's very DIY. You know, you make your own skate videos, and yeah, I think that's you know, that's one similarity to music. You have to just make it happen yourself and use what you have. Yeah, when I first started making music, I did an EP under the name Seeper, and I put it on the internet just for like as a free download. I think this was even before the time, like MySpace. It was 2003 or 4 or something. And some chain of events some random chain of events made it so that I ended up in Germany opening up for a band called The Books, like playing my third show ever. And in the audience was a guy from a label called Morr Music who just came and talked to me after the show and asked me if I want to do some records with him, and now I'm doing my fifth record with that label, I think. It was just I guess it was pretty lucky. I put this album online for everyone to download, and I got to know this guy called Ed from Grizzly Bear. It's just a band from America, and we did a split 7-inch on a German label, and then they asked me to come to Germany and play, and I had never played before. Didn't even think that I was going to play live. So then we went to Berlin and played, and I met Thomas. And yeah, then I kind of haven't stopped since. It was a big, lucky coincidence. I changed my name from Sin Fang Boost to just Sin Fang after the first Sin Fang album, basically because everyone just started calling me Sin Fang, calling the project Sin Fang, because it's much easier than saying Sin Fang Boost. So it kind of just fell off pretty naturally after the first album. Sin Fang doesn't mean anything. It's just I want to make up a name that didn't mean anything. So you weren't stuck with some stupid name that meant something. I've done all the cover art with my girlfriend. It's kind of like a collaboration when we do that. And then my brother, little brother, does most of my music videos, and my father takes the photographs, so it's like a family collaboration. I originally went to art school and studied visual art, and I guess I thought I was going to be a visual artist. And on my second year of my studies, I got a record contract and started touring and doing albums, so that kind of just took over my life. But I still graduated from school as a visual artist, and I still paint and draw, and released a book last year. I have like one or two exhibitions every year, and I still really enjoy that, but I guess I would call myself a musician rather than a visual artist these days. My first art exhibition was in a skate shop called Tindalekkun or The Missing Link. So it was probably when I was 18 or something. And it was a few of us, and we had all these collections of skateboarding photographs and of us partying. My new album is called Flowers, because the theme of the album is kind of like teenage years, and I thought Flowers was a good name for that, because that's like the flowers are used both for like a happy and sad occasion, and I think the teenage years are lots of ups and downs. And that's why I picked that name. Most of my music videos with my little brother, who's a filmmaker. And that's very good, because I can pay him very little and also be a dick to him without feeling guilty, because I'm related to him. And it's good, because we have a similar aesthetic and ideas about videos, and also my girlfriend has done some music videos for me too. I guess I like to work with people who are close to me, because then I can also have a say in the videos without it being awkward. yes, having music in skate movies is a pretty big deal for me. I had one song in a Habitat movie, and then there's going to be one new song in Siggi's part for the for Alien Workshop. And growing up as a teenager, me and my friends got to know lots of music by watching skate movies. It was like before the download era. The skateboards I'm doing with Alien have just like a mixed collage of drawings and paintings by me, and it also there's also a download code for my new album that comes with each deck. Yeah, I'm very excited to have you know, my paintings and drawings on a skateboard. It's been a dream of mine since I started skateboarding, and yeah, it's also really fun to have your like name on a skateboard without being very good on a skateboard. every skateboarder's dream. Yeah, I started off by pushing myself Mongo, like they say.